हेलो नमस्ते, मैं हूं डॉक्टर सौरभ एंड वेलकम टू साइंस या ब्रेन री। जीन स्टेलिंग मींस जीन्स को चुराना। सो जीन स्टेलिंग इज द प्रोसेस वेयर स्पीसीज और एन ऑर्गेनिज्म दे पिल्फर द जीन्स फ्रॉम अनदर स्पीसीज और ऑर्गेनिज्म एंड दीज स्टोलन जीन्स दे आर यूज्ड फॉर देयर सर्वाइवल। सो वी कैन से दैट दिस इज द केस ऑफ जीन स्मगलिंग एंड दिस जीन स्मगलिंग इज हैपनिंग इन नेचर for million of years, but it has been decoded rarely in the metazoa or animal kingdom, but it is found mostly in microorganisms like fungi, bacteria or viruses, where these organisms they steal the genes from another organism for their survival or even from the plants. But recently scientists have decoded such a case of gene smuggling in the insect kingdom, where a white fly hijacked a plant gene about 35 million years ago for its survival and to detoxify the plant defense system, which are plant secondary metabolites. So we can say that this is the first known example of natural gene transfer from a plant to animal. So let's start the discussion in detail about the gene smuggling in nature. You can see here the article which is published in the, you can say that the Hindu, the first known gene transfer from the plant to insect identified. So this publication, this research publication, it has been published in the journal Cell. You can see here that white fly hijacks a plant detoxification gene that neutralizes plant toxins. So according to this publication, it has been found that white fly uses a stolen plant gene to overcome the host plant defenses, and that may offer the route to new pest control strategies. And we can see that this white fly, it is one of the most devastating pernicious pest of agricultural crops, and it really wreaks a havoc by destroying the crop plants. And this sucking type of pest means this white fly, which is a sucking type of pest like your aphids, it actually causes the billion of losses globally, and it causes the crop loss by feeding also and by transmitting the viruses also. So we can see that this white fly is also one of the vector of various viruses which causes the huge yield losses to the crop plants. And if you see about the white fly, so white fly is a, you can see here that white fly is a small tiny insect which is white in color from the beak's mouth parts or everything, and this is actually sap sucking pest which actually suck the saps from the host plants, and it's both its adult and its nymph. Okay, these are the nymphs of white fly and these are the adult white fly. Both of these, they causes havoc, and both of these they feed on the plant leaves, and mostly you can see that they are found on the under surface of the leaves, means leaf ke lower surface pe pai jate hain, on the under surface of the leaves, and you can see that they are mostly found in the clusters. Okay, so if you see that life cycle of the white fly, you can see that within 18 to 28 days it actually completes its life cycle, and from the adult stage you can see if that when they lay the eggs, and from the eggs the first instar nymphs, and from the first instar nymphs it comes to second and third instar nymph, and then fourth instar nymph, where they red eye pupae, they develop into red eye pupae, and after that they hatch into the adults. Okay, so we can see that this minute, actually this minute white fly insect, this is a small tiny white fly, it actually causes the havoc in the agricultural crops. So, and this white fly, which is scientifically Bemisia tabaci, okay, we can say that it is one of the most destructive plant pest, and actually it suck the saps from the plant species or from the leaves, and they actually secrete a, you can see here that they secrete a honeydew. Okay, and this honeydew, it further act as a ground for the means breeding of various types of the mold or other diseases actually. So you can say that this is the honeydew secretion, which is which happens after the white fly attacks on the host plant, and they start sucking the sap from the host plant leaves, and there is a honeydew secretion, and this honeydew secretion further it is, means we can say that it acts as a ground for breeding of other diseases like your mold. Okay, and it has been found that these white flies, they are also the vector for more than about 100 plant pathogenic viruses. So these are the some of the important example of viruses which are transmitted by the white fly. So you can see that these are the virus like your Bagmo virus in the Geminiviridae family, and your Ipomo viruses, and your Carla viruses, and by this way they actually transmit more than 100 of plant viruses and causes a huge yield loss. So actually in this study, actually it has been found that white fly alone is not sufficient to cause such a huge yield loss. Actually, it pilfered the gene from the plant system about 35 million years ago, and that's why it became adaptive, or you can say that it became so much devastating that it has now a host range of more than 600 plant species. Means now it is causing the damage to more than 600 types of plant species. So such a devastating insect pest of agricultural crops and causing losses in billions. So we can say that this study actually explained the reason that's why white fly or this Bamisia tabsai is so adept at munching on the crops. As I told you that more than 600 plant species. Actually, what happened? This white fly, this minute insect, it actually swiped the gene from the plants, and that enables it to neutralize the plant toxins which they use for the defense against the insect pest attack. Okay, but this white fly actually it steals the genes from the plant system about 35 million years ago, and that's why now it is able to overcome the plant defense mechanism, and it causes the serious losses to the crop plants. So if you see that this is the case of gene smuggling, and if you see that gene stealing or the stolen genes in nature, okay, so for millions of years if it like insects, means these white flies, these tiny insects, actually for millions of years they actually incorporated the portion of DNA from the plant into their genome. Means they steal the genes from the plant system into their own genome to overcome the plant defense mechanism, and that's why we can see that the some of the species of the white fly, they could owe the part of, that's why we can say that white fly, they could owe the part of their predatory powers to the genes from the other organisms. And we can say that there are so many other examples where the insect pest or the organisms, they have stolen the genes from another species for their survival. If you see that, if I give you some more examples, you can see that one of the major insect pest of the coffee, okay, that is a coffee berry borer. Okay, this is the coffee berry borer, and actually it bores the coffee, and you can see that this coffee berry borer actually it plundered the genes, or it pilfered or steal the genes, microbial genes, to extract the nutrition from this coffee berries. Okay, because you know that in the coffee berries majority of portion is carbohydrate, and these insects, they can't easily digest the carbohydrate, these coffee berry borer actually. So that's why what they did for million of years, means their ancestor actually, they steal the genes from the from microbes, actually from the bacteria. Okay, they steal the genes from bacteria which is found in their own gut. Okay, so they steal the genes, which genes? That is HHMAN1 gene from the bacteria, so that they can easily digest the carbohydrate when they feed on these coffee berries. And these are the one of the major insect pest of the coffee, which can cause the loss to entire harvest. Means they can diminish the entire coffee yield. So if I give you another example, that is your Betaloid rotifers. So these are the rotifers. Actually, these are some aquatic pest. Okay, these erotifers, these are the aquatic organisms, and they have such a means excellent features or excellent facts that they are grabbing the attention of the scientist, and because of their excellent features, you see that these rotifers. If I tell you some of the interesting facts about these rotifers, actually they are the group of the animals which completely abandon the sex. Means they don't need any sex for their perpetuation of their generation. Okay, so it has been found that for about 18 million years, so there is no male of these rotifers. Means no male has been found, no male has ever been found for these rotifers for 80 million years, and their only females are found. And actually these females, how they perpetuate, means how they reproduce, they from cloning themselves. So how they reproduce their generation? By the cloning process. So this is, you can see that this is the interesting case, that where animal species which have no male, means no male it has ever been found for the 80 million years. And you can see that this rotifers, only female species are found, and they reproduce by cloning. Okay, actually these rotifers, they also actually steal the genes from, we can say that these also steal the genes from organisms for their survival. Okay, and if I tell you one more fact, that these rotifers, they are also most resistant to the radiations. Okay, or we can say that they are the most radiation resistant animals on the planet, these rotifers, and they can tolerate doses 100 times more than that would kill a human. So these are also most resistant to the radiations. Similarly, there is another example where a fungus actually they steal the genes from the bacteria. Means this is the case of, for example, where a fungi, means the wheat fungus actually, which steal the genes from a bacteria for its survival. So we can say that there are some other examples of hijacking the genes, means where one organism hijack the genes of other organisms. So anyway, if we come back to the white fly, that which is the first known example of natural gene transfer from a plant to the animal, means where a white fly hijacked a plant gene for million of years, about 35 million years ago. So actually we can see that in the plenty of the plant species, means many of the plant species, you can see that secondary metabolites are found, means some kind of group of chemicals, they are found in the plant species, different plant species, which they use for the as a defense mechanism against the different insect pest. Okay, we can see that for more than 400 million years of co-evolution with the insect herbivores, the plants have developed a diverse spectrum of morphological, molecular and biochemical defenses to the insect attack. And if you see that one of the example of biochemical defenses, so plant secondary metabolites, they are one of the most useful weapon of the plants which they use against the insect. So in this case, what has happened, that white fly actually steal the genes from the plant system. Which gene? So white fly actually they steal the genes which actually detoxify the plant toxin. Which plant toxin? Phenolic glycoside. Okay, so actually what has happened, actually you can see that when the white fly brings about 35 million years ago, they actually steal the genes. Which gene? BTPMAT1 gene. So white fly, through the natural gene transfer, by the horizontal gene transfer process, the white fly actually they steal the genes, they pilfer the genes BTPMAT1 gene from plant system. And in many different plant system, actually this gene it encodes for, you can say that, phenolic malonyl glucosides transferase. Okay, actually this BTPMAT1 gene, actually it encodes for phenolic glucoside malonyl transferase. Okay, this gene. Okay, so but this gene do, In the plant system, as I told you, there are different secondary metabolites, and one of the secondary metabolite is phenolic glucoside. Okay, and phenolic glucoside, and actually whitefly bug did, and this phenolic glucoside actually they act as a defense mechanism in the plant system against the insect pest attack. So, but the whitefly did actually for its survival. Whitefly actually they steal the gene BTP MAT1, which encodes for phenolic glucoside melanin transferase. Okay, so this gene actually, but means whitefly has this gene BTP MAT1. So, but this gene do when they feed on this plant system which have the phenolic glucoside. So, but this gene do actually this gene do melanylation. Okay, means this gene which encodes for the phenolic glucoside melanyl transferase. So, but it actually detoxify this compound to means phenolic glycoside. Means this gene actually detoxify this compound to phenolic melanyl glucosides. Mein. Okay. So, this gene kya karta hai ki is phenolic glucosides ko in secondary metabolite ko detoxify kar deta hai aur kis mein convert kar deta hai, phenolic melanyl glucoside mein convert kar deta hai. To matlab ek tarah se jo inka detoxify effect jo hai of these plant secondary metabolites, this gene neutralizes the toxic effects of these plant secondary metabolites. So how, that's why whitefly, we can say that whitefly they stolen the genes BTPM81 to neutralize the effect of plant toxins. Okay, for their survival. So, if to test the hypothesis further, they did that scientist, but the scientist did actually this type of plant toxin, it is also found in the tomato plants. So, actually, but the scientist did, they actually means silenced the whitefly gene, this whitefly gene that is BTP MAT1. तो उन्होंने बाइट फ्लाई के ये जो जीन है BTPMAT1 उसको साइलेंस कर दिया, मतलब उसको एक तरह से न्यूट्रलाइज कर दिया. तो अगर बाइट फ्लाई में वो जीन साइलेंस हो गया मतलब वो एक्सप्रेस नहीं होगा, तो उससे क्या हुआ कि जो बाइट फ्लाई में जो वो जीन है जो कि उसको मतलब उसके जो डिटॉक्सिफाई कर दे रहा है प्लांट टॉक्सिन को, तो वो नहीं कर पाएगा. तो दैट्स व्हाई बट दे डिड साइंटिस्ट इट देन दे बाइट फ्लाई अटैक्ड द टोमेटो प्लांट बिकॉज दिस जीन हैज बीन साइलेंस्ड इन द बाइट फ्लाई. सो व्हेन दे अटैक्ड द टोमेटो प्लांट, so in the means that on the transgenic tomato plant where this gene is silenced by the scientist. Okay, so when the whitefly attacked the transgenic plant, it was found safe actually. So whitefly could not cause a huge loss to that particular plant. So in this way we can say that actually this finding, it has provided a opportunity to keep the whiteflies away but not the harmful beneficial insects such as pollinators. Otherwise we go for the your application of insecticides or pesticides. So we can say that this is, but how these bite flies actually they manage to swipe a plant gene is unclear. Means how they bite flies actually they steal the genes from the plants for millions of years, by which process actually bite fly actually they have stolen the genes from the plants, this is unclear. But scientists have speculated that one of the phenomenon could be that this is mediated by the viruses. Means they thought that they speculated that virus within the plant they may have been taken up by this bite fly. Okay, means the virus which actually taken up this gene BTP MAT1 gene, and the when the bite fly actually they feed on the plant system, so with the virus on the plant system actually along with the virus that gene actually that entered into the insect genome. Okay, so that is the speculation actually, and this needs further investigation in detail. But we can say that this is the first known example of a natural gene transfer from a plant system to the animal system. Okay, and for million of years, insects have found the insects and both the plants, they have found different ways, different defense mechanisms to protect themselves against their enemies. Okay. So with this, I would like to end today's lecture. And if you like the video, please kindly share karein, subscribe karein, and like karein. And I will say thank you. Stay happy, stay blessed, and stay safe. Thank you.